Hello everyone, hope you and your family is safe and doing well. Today I'm here to talk about a new NFO which Mirae Asset is coming out with. It's India's first ETF based on Nifty Financial Services Index. And before I talk about the product, I want to talk about why financial services sector makes sense from an investment point of view. Now, financial services sector plays a huge role in economic development of our country, especially in case of developing economies like India. While financial services sector has grown at a greater pace than economy and the broad market as well in recent decades, and the financial inclusion across products and services have improved, we still have a long way to go to reach even global averages. For example, the overall bank credit to GDP ratio remains fairly low at 56% as of 2020, whereas in emerging market peers, it stands at 135% and at 88% for advanced economies. Similarly, as of 2019, the penetration of life insurance in India was just 2.8%, and for non-life insurance was much lower at 0.94%. Globally, insurance penetration was 3.3% for the life segment and 3.8% for the non-life segment. Similarly, while the AUM of Indian mutual fund industry stands in excess of 30 lakh crores, it merely represents 12% of India's GDP compared to the global averages, which is at 55%. India is expected to become the fourth largest private wealth market globally by 2028. On the other side, NBFCs have gained importance by being able to supply credit in addition to banks and have seen its market share improve from 12% in FY08 to 20% in FY20. NBFCs are now important players in auto, housing, and gold financing businesses, and this is expected to grow much more. Another upcoming segment in financial services is fintech, especially in form of digital payment. Overall, transaction of more than 19 lakh crores has been done via UPI and 1 lakh crore via RuPay cards in 2021. Along with this, we are seeing innovations and more offerings in segments like broking, etc. So not only this segment is underpenetrated, which provides a lot of room for growth of these companies and growth of sector as a whole, but also with the advent of new products and services backed by technology, the scope of the entire segment is tremendous in coming decades. Further, these digital innovations are also expected to have spillover effect on traditional means of financial services like banks, as they will help in quicker settlement, will help the operational cost, and is expected to improve the overall efficiency of the financial markets. Now, from an investment point of view, if an investor wants to take exposure in this space, Mirae Asset Nifty Financial Services ETF may be the right product for you. The index provides exposure to 20 companies representing various sub-segments of financial services, from private sector to public sector banks, from general insurance to life insurance, from NBFC to HFC, and from AMCs to other financial institutions, and possibly may also include new listings from spaces like fintech in future if it satisfies the index criteria. Now, this index has a rich history of over 15 years and is one of the very few indices on which there is futures and option. Financial services as a sector has performed well historically. For instance, in last 5 years, Nifty Financial Services Index has generated a return of 18.3% per annum compared to 15.1% by Nifty 50 and 14.6% by Nifty Bank. Even on a rolling return basis, for an investment horizon of 3 years, the average return from Nifty Financial Services Index has been 17% compared to 12.4% by Nifty 50. Now, this data has been averaged out for last 7 years. Now, the reason to take passive exposure in financial services is also pretty strong. Firstly, no regular plan of active BFSI equity fund has outperformed the Nifty Financial Services Index in last 3, 5, or 7 year period. And also, the cost of our Nifty Financial Services ETF is expected to be around 0.13%, which is just 13 basis points, which is much lower than the cost at which active mutual funds are available at. It also carries no active fund manager risk of underperformance. To conclude, the importance of financial sector as growth engine for Indian economy, along with the current low penetration of most of the segments in this space and increasing innovation in products and services, represents significant opportunity for the sector. Mirae Asset Nifty Financial Services ETF may be the right investment vehicle to take exposure in this space. The NFO opens on 22nd July and will close on other platforms on 26th July and on AMC website at 3 p.m. on 29th July. The allotment will be done based on the closing value of Nifty Financial Services Index as on 30th July. The scheme will reopen for transaction directly with the AMC on 3rd August and will be registered on both exchanges within 5 working days from the date of the allotment. We hope for your participation in this NFO. Happy investing. Take care and thank you for watching this video.
Mutual fund investments are subject to market risks. Read all scheme-related documents carefully.